By the time the enemy knows the Raptadon Hunters are pursuing them, it's often too late. These skinks and their reptilian mounts swiftly close on the foe, bombarding them with javelins and luring them to their doom. And in this video, we'll be showing you how to paint a Raptadon Hunter to battle ready. You'll see that we have built the Raptadon on its base and the Skink Hunter on a sub-assembly peg. This is for ease of painting and we can avoid a lot of unwanted mistakes. Then we undercoated our models, and for this we have used wraith bone to give our Raptadon skin a nice cream colour. And it's always a good idea to have a pot of wraith bone to hand too, to tidy up any mistakes we make. The paints we'll be using are on the screen right now. You'll also be needing some other materials like mediums and brushes, but feel free to use water instead of mediums and any brushes you feel comfortable using. We only suggest these to make your painting easier. If you are new to painting or want to know more about the paints and techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos. We'll be starting off by applying a mix of one part Achillean Green to two parts Contrast Medium for the skink skin. It's also best to get this over the edges of other details, making sure that we get every recess covered in this colour. We can tidy up any areas later with the next colours. Just be mindful of heavy pooling in those recesses. You can always soak away with a dry brush. Achillean Green is a great colour for many of your Seraphon, having a slightly teal tone perfect for scaly skin. Next, we'll use Rust Grey for the fingers and feet of the Raptadon and the scales on the skink's back. We'll be using a small layer brush for these, as some of these details are quite small or in tricky to reach places, giving us a little bit more control. As Rust Grey is a layer paint, you might find that you need a couple of thin coats to get a solid coverage. Now we'll paint the feathers on the Raptadon and the top feather on the skink's head with Mephiston Red. You can also use this colour on the gems on the shield and inside their mouths. Just be careful when you apply this colour as we'll be close to other painted details, so use a suitable size brush. Here we have used a small base brush and a small layer brush. With that red painted, we can move on to Morghast Bone for the teeth on both models, the skink's claws and weapon wrappings. Just like before, use a small enough brush for those areas and keep that brush pointed for more control. Morghast Bone is a slightly dirty cream colour, so it's perfect for natural claws, teeth, and funnily enough, bones. Next, we'll paint the Raptadon's spines, shield face, weaponry, and ropes with Corvus Black. If you find that you got some of this colour onto the Raptadon's body, you can always tidy up with our pot of wraith bone. You can be a bit messy here when applying it to the shield, as we'll be covering most of the detail with our next colour. Our next colour is Skullcrusher Brass, and we'll be using this on all of the metal details on both parts of the model. A small layer brush will be helpful here, as there's a lot of small totems hanging around both of the models. If you aren't sure where these are, check out the box art for some ideas. There are quite a lot of gold details on these models, and just apply a couple of thin coats to get a solid gold cover. Now we can apply Rhinox Hide to the claws and weapon shafts. Alternatively, you can use this colour for any ropes as well, depending on what you prefer for your army. Rhinox Hide is a rich dark brown, but if you want a lighter tone for these models, why not try Steel Legion Drab? Remember that you can tidy up any mistakes with any of our previous paints if you smudge and make a mistake. Rhinox Hide is a rich dark brown, adding a bit of darkness to a mostly bright colour scheme. And for our last base paint, we'll be using Avalon Sunset for the eyes on both models, and the rest of the feathers on the skink. Just take your time, as there is a lot of paint on our model, and we want to avoid tidying up with our previous colours where possible. Now is the best time to tidy up any areas we have left over with Wraithbone, as now we'll be moving on to some shades. For our first shade, we'll be using Seraphon Sepia. We'll thin down one part shade to two parts Lamia Medium for a lighter colour for the Raptadon's body and legs. Just make sure it doesn't pull too heavily. We want to define the skin and the muscles. Then we'll use it straight out of the pot for the Avalon Sunset details. Even with that first shade applied, you can see the Raptadon is already coming to life. Next, we'll thin one part Fuegan Orange with three parts Lamy Medium for the top half of the Raptadon's body, avoiding those belly and legs that we painted earlier. If you do get any on those areas, just take a clean damp brush and soak it away whilst wet. Then we'll use it straight out of the pot for the Raptadon's most raised areas on the back and the fur on the neck and the arms. Apply it in smaller amounts and build up that colour. Once the orange is dry, we'll apply Sol Light Grey to the Raptadon's face. Be careful of the gold and yellow details, as we don't want this colour to create a misty layer over them. We want the colour to shade nicely in those recesses, so if you think it's too heavy on the raised areas, you can tidy up a little bit with Wraithbone. Next, we'll shade Skullcrusher Brass and Rhinox Hide details with Agrax Earthshade. We don't want a heavy shade over these, so use it lightly and with a small layer brush. This will help you get a bit more control when applying it. With that shade on, now the gold and the brown details are standing out even more, making them look grimy and worn. And finally, we'll use Nuln Oil to shade the Rust Grey and Mephiston Red details to darken those recesses. You won't need much, as we don't want to lose the vibrancy of these colours. A small amount at a time will be plenty. And there we are, our Raptadon Hunter is now battle ready, ready to strike fear with their savage and rapid ambushes. You can see that I have based it in Armageddon Dunes, but you can pick whatever colour you want. If you want to know more about basing models, check out our technical paints video all about them. For more tutorials, tips and techniques, head to citadelcolour.com, or you can also head into a Warhammer store where our friendly staff will help you out. Well, we hope you enjoyed this painting video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!